to welcome all of you who are listening. And now we want to start our science demonstration. Now, during this past week and the week before that, in our morning worships, we have been looking at Psalms 46. So let's turn in our Bibles to Psalms 46. And we want to read especially the first three verses. God is our refuge and strength, the very present help in trouble. Therefore will we not fear, though the earth be removed and the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof. We're going to see a demonstration of like a whirlpool, but it's called tornado in a bottle. And if you've been a teacher, perhaps you've done this in your classroom, you can see several demonstrations of it on YouTube, I believe. But let's look at our next slide, and which is Psalms 46, 1-3. We've just read that. And also I think of Mark 4:39. And he arose, that's Jesus speaking, and rebuked the wind and said unto the sea, peace be still. And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. Next slide. It's a picture of a whirlpool. A whirlpool is a bunch of turbulence in water. Turbulence can occur in the air. If you've been in a plane and you've experienced turbulence, you know that air currents can cause this. Water can cause this. And slide 5 is a picture of something like what we're going to do. You see two 2-liter clear plastic bottles neck to neck. And we have one set up here on our table. But let's move on. Here's another picture, slide 6. And if you look carefully in that top bottle, you'll see a funnel like a tornado of water there. And slide 7 shows a young fella holding his tornado in a bottle with the whirlpool in the top bottle. And slide 8 is a gigantic whirlpool in a bottle. You would see this if you were in San Francisco and went to the Exploratorium. And this is a huge, at least more than one story high, of an example of a tornado in a bottle. Slide 9, what you need, and you can do this easily at home. Two 2-liter clear plastic soda bottles. A way to connect the bottles, duct tape will work, and we have duct tape on ours. You need to fill one bottle 3/4 full. Slide 10 tells you the procedures. And you take the cap of one of the bottles and drill a hole in it about a half or 3/4 diameter across the cap so that the water can flow through. Then you put the empty bottle, and let me put my mics down over here. Let's see if this works. Do you think I can clip this one on? Yes, you're right. So that one is on. And so here is our demonstration of a tornado in a bottle. Two plastic bottles, one bottle 3/4 full, and I put some confetti in it so it might help you see the whirling better. And what we're going to do, Pastor's going to help me with this, we're going to quickly invert it, and at the same time after inverted, do some swift circular motions to get the water turbulated, and then you'll see something happen. And it's so much fun. After it goes through, you can invert it again and try again. So Pastor's going to come over here and invert this and quickly add some turbulence to the water.
Well, we're glad to be able to do this. And so we have our bottle, and we're going to make room just in case there's water that comes out. We know that that probably isn't going to happen. But we were going to bring a wash tub or a little tub base, and we forgot to put it in. So what we're going to do, we're going to take it and upside down, and then we're going to whirl fast. So we're going to give it a couple of whirls and then let it set. And we're watching it starting to spout.
Do you see it, Ashley?
Yeah.
Wow. I hope that comes through on the video. Oh, it's so pretty.
We should do this again, and we'll zoom in a little bit this time on the bottles as we go up and down, okay?
So what he's going to do is try again, invert and swirl.
Wow. This one's working really well. It's spraying out nicely.
Okay, can you see it, Ashley? Yes. She's our camera person right now. What a beautiful whirlpool. Now, whirlpools, like I say, occur in water. Ashley can try it, yes. We'll let her give it a whirl, but she hasn't practiced this. We practiced this yesterday to make sure it worked. You invert it and swirl quickly. Let's see what happens. Our mini scientist is going to do this. Well, it worked. You did a good job. You're a good scientist. Look at that. That's so pretty. But if this were in nature, you want to do it one more time? I'm sure you do. Okay, one more time. Invert and swirl. You see the confetti going down? All right. Thank you, Ashley. Now, what I'd like for you to think about is all of these little pieces of confetti in there are like our troubles. And this whirlpool is like Satan. He's sucking us in. And this is what happened to the life of Joseph. Not only was he sold into slavery, but then he was faced with prison. And with no sentencing, no trial, no nothing, he was just thrown into prison. And for all he knew, he'd be there for the rest of his life. But the Bible says that the Lord was with him two times. This is the first time in the Bible that we have this expression that the Lord was with someone. And it occurred when Joseph was a slave in Potiphar's household. The Bible says the Lord was with him then. And when Joseph was cast into prison, the Bible again tells us that the Lord was with him. So no matter if it feels like you're in a whirlwind, you can't get out, you're being sucked down, God is with you. He's promised never to leave you. And this is a little illustration that God can calm the waters, even though it seems like a whirlwind. Seems like things are out of control. God is really in charge of all of this. And he was in charge of, Ashley's doing this again because it's so much fun. And Benjamin, if you're at home and you want to try that, you just need two empty 2-liter bottles, some duct tape, and at least one of the lids of the bottle that you can bore a hole in. And then you just do this, and it works. The first time we tried this, we didn't put a lid on it. And the water from one bottle to the next just went zooming out. And it made a whirlpool, but like in 5 seconds. Yeah. This one is about 15 seconds. Okay, so that's our science demonstration. Thank you for looking and joining us during this demonstration, and we hope to have another one next Sabbath.